Fan request, Katsuki Bakugo, ex-artist listener. This is a fluff, written by LarryMillie2683 on Wattpad, link in the description below. You and Katsuki have been dating since you were 2. Since you 2 were 13. You still remember how he confessed his feelings for you. He was blushing like a tomato, which really surprised you, but you thought it was cute. You had feelings for him since you were 6 years old. He was 4 when he had a crush on you. You were even friends with Izuku. You tried to protect him from getting bullied by Katsuki, but it made him even more wanting to bully Izu. And did I forget to mention that he will get jealous of Izuku? He wanted to have more time with you, but you spent more time with Izuku. Ever since you were 5 years old, you loved to draw constantly. Katsuki loves your drawings, but he would say that it looks bad, but you know he loves them. You can see it from his eyes whenever you show him your drawings. Now both of you are in UA. I had the same classes together. Your quirk for this story is super strength and invisibility, same as Violet from The Incredibles, but without the strong force. Wayne's point of view. Sparky, that's your nickname for him, has been dating every clingy today. It's our 2-year anniversary, dating each other. He would sneak up behind me and hug me from around my waist, even when I'm talking to one of my friends, especially my male friends. He would still hug my waist, which I thought was pretty cute. He would pause whenever I would talk to my friends, and he would glare at them, which made me giggle a bit. The bell rang, since lunchtime is over. I healed Sparky's hand while we were heading back to class. When we entered the class, he gave me a peck on my cheek. Whenever you're talking to your friends, you better think of me, he said with a small dust of blush on his cheeks. A giggle, which made him blush even more. I gave him a small kiss on his lips and said, "Don't worry, Sparky. I love you and only you, okay?" While I was wrapping my arms around his waist, he gave me a tch and returned the hug. No PSA during school hours, Ellen and Bakugo. That's not very appropriate for both of you, know that. Ida yelled at us while moving his arms like a robot. We both let go of each other, and Sparky yelled at Irken. Shut it, Four Eyes. Don't tell me what to do with my girlfriend. I flashed like a tomato, and I used my invisibility quirk, and walked past Sparky and Ida, while they were yelling at each other. When I went to my seat, I turned off my quirk, but I was still blushing. Phew. You okay, Wayne-san? Izuku asked, wearily. I'm okay, Izu. Don't worry. Kachan being Kachan? I nodded shyly at him. He chuckled nervously. Me and Izu had the seat next to each other, so we talked for a bit until Aizawa came in the room for the class to begin. Time skip, still Wayne's point of view. Now the class is over, Sparky was waiting next to the desk, while I was putting my stuff back in my backpack. Ready? Finally, give me your hand. I gave him my hand, since Ida wasn't there to tutor us about not doing PSA. We walked out of school, still holding hands. I love holding his hands because he's so warm. And he hold mine like a glass, which I thought was really sweet of him. I stood on my tippy toes and gave him a kiss on his cheek. He glared at me with a small blush on his cheek. What the hell was that for? What? Can't I give a kiss to my cute boyfriend? Whatever. Anyway, meet me at my house in 2 hours. Don't forget, he said to me. Alright, I said with a smile. We both separated our ways to go to our house. When I rode to my house, I was alone, since my parents don't come to my home often because of work. So I went to my room and changed into blue ripped jeans and orange hoodie that made reprints of Katsuki's hero costume. I did a pretty good job when I made it. He's going to be surprised when he sees me in this, since I never show him, and I never show this to him. I clasp my hands together while saying, "All right, let's finish this drawing. I'm so excited to show him." I walk to my desk and got out my textbook, my sketchbook. I work on a drawing for Sparky. The drawing shows me and Kasky holding hands, walking under a cherry blossom tree. We are looking at each other, our eyes covered up by our hair, and our backs were facing the front. We were wearing an orange hoodie that said King, with a black crown on the bottom of the word, and wearing gray jeans, a black hoodie that said Queen in orange, and the crown was at the bottom one of the word, and it was also in orange. I'm almost done with the drawing, just finished the blossom, and make a heart in between us, as we're looking at each other. Time skipped to 1 hour and 45 minutes. Yeah, I'm done, yay! I like my drawing, and I did a good job. I put my signature on the bottom of the drawing in cursive. I look at my phone, and I had 50 minutes left to go, so I just brushed my teeth and put on some clear lip gloss. As I was getting my stuff, I got a text from Katsuki. Sparky boy. Are you on the way to my house? Angel. That's a nickname for you. I'm putting on my shoes right now. I'll be there soon. Sparkly boy. Well, don't take too long. Got it. Angel. Alright, my cute explosion boy. Ooh. He's probably blushing and cursing. As I was walking to Sparkly's house, I checked my drawing to see if the picture didn't mess up, since I used paint for the cherry blossom. They didn't make a mess with the rest of the drawing. I was still happy with the work I did. I really hope he likes it. If not, then I'll keep it for myself. It will hurt me if he doesn't like it, but I still love him. I arrived at Kasuki's house. I knocked to the door 2 times and I saw Mitsuki. She smiled at me and gave me a bone-crushing hug. Hi, Wayne. Congratulations for 2 years of being together with my dumb son. Hi, Mitsuki. And thank you. I hope he likes my present for him. I said nervously, huh? Can I see? I bet it looks beautiful. Sure, I guess. Here. As I'm giving her the drawing, she gasped with a smile. Mr. Bakugo was coming to the door. Hello, Wayne. How are you? Oh my goodness. That looks real beautiful, Wayne. He says nicely. When he saw the drawing I made. Thank you. I said with a smile. If my dumb son doesn't like it, I'll hit him on the head. She was handing me back the drawing. A swear dropped, but I still smiled. They entered me in the house, and the house looked really pretty inside. Kasuki is in his room. If you want to see him, when? Mitsuki told me as she entered the kitchen. Okay, see you in a few minutes. Have fun. I walked to his room and knocked on his door. Kasuki is pointing at him. As we finished cleaning my room, I heard a knock at the door. It must be Angel. I went to my door and opened to reveal a beautiful girlfriend that I was dating for 2 years. I can't believe it. 2 years of us dating each other. I was wondering why she did choose me. She could have chosen that damn nerd, Deku. But no, she chose me. Hi, Sparky! Her voice. I could never get tired of her voice. She put a piece of paper on my desk so she can give me a hug. I wrapped my arms around her waist, hugging her back. She was a little shorter than me, so I was able to put my chin on her head. Hey, dumbass. You came just in time. Just like I told you to. She giggles. What I said to her. I've started to freaking giggles. Means so much to me. I break the hug and look at her. Glimmering eye-colored eyes. They are really beautiful. I kiss her roughly, but with passion too. She smiles at me, and she kisses back. I freaking love her. She will never get replaced with anyone. She's mine, and only mine. Wayne's point of view. As we were kissing, he smirked. Oh boy. He pushed me on the bed, and with his tongue in my mouth, I tense a bit, but I let him. As we were making out, I felt a tear drop on the face of my eyes. I was surprised. My baby was crying. I let go of the kiss. He started to cry even harder. I started to worry. Oh, why are you crying, Sparky? As I was putting my hand on his cheek, he clung to my hand. I put his big hand on top of my small hand. He started to smile and open his eyes so he can look at me.
Why?
He asked me, which confused me.
What do you mean? Why did you freaking choose me?
I was shocked that he asked me that question, but I smiled at him because I know my answer. Because I love you. Even though you can be a bit of a jerk at times, you can be caring, loving, and strong. You are the one that I love, and I will always love you. Even when you are mean, I'll never stop loving you, Sparky. I loved him with a passionate and confident. He came out and hugged me. I hugged him back and gave him a kiss on the forehead. We cuddled for at least 17 minutes. After we let go of each other, rubbed my nose against him. That made him laugh a bit.
Is that why you made that hoodie that represent my hero costume?
I said with a smirk, which of course made me blush in response. This shows you that I love you, even when you're wearing your hero costume. As I kissed his cheek, he pulled out a small box. I was curious what was inside. He sat on the bed and I did the same. He opened it and I started to tear up. He brought us a promising ring. I was speechless. He started to blush. I started to speak.
Wayan, will you wear this promise ring with me? With me as we stay together?
He looked at the ring. Looked at the right, but the box was still facing me. My tears started to fall out of my eyes, and I hugged him with arm strength.
Yes!
I said happily.
Don't freaking cry, dumbass.
He said with a smile. He took out the ring and the one with diamonds. I put it on my left finger. And I took the ring with the black half of a heart and put it on my left finger. He leaned to me and kissed me with passion. We kissed for a few seconds and then we started to separate for the kiss. He asked a question.
So what is the piece of paper doing on my freaking parents' love so much?
As you played with my hair, I almost forgot about my art. I got off the bed, went to his desk, and picked up the drawing. I started to blush and gave the art to him. I hope you like it. With a hint of nervousness, he took the picture from my hand and scanned the drawing. His eyes widened when he saw, and he started to smile and cry too.
I don't like it. I love it so freaking much.
As he got off the bed and wrapped his arms around your waist, he hugged you with strength, with tenderness. It's best not to hurt.
I love you so freaking much, Angel.
I started to cry again, because he loves my art and he calls me Angel, which was the very first time that he called me Angel. I hugged him back and buried my face in his neck. Little did both of you know, Mitsuki and Masaru have been hearing the whole entire time, and they were crying with tears of joy that their aggressive son is being loved and showed someone that he loves. Love and affection.
Oh my god, that was so cute. But no further ado, I'll see you guys next video. Bye!